हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू इन्फिनिटी आईएएस एकेडमी। आई एम एडवोकेट शिरीष त्यागी एंड टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट पेरोल एंड फरलॉ। सो पेरोल इज बेसिकली द रिलीज ऑफ अ प्रिजनर फ्रॉम द प्रिजन बिफोर द एक्सपायरी ऑफ हिज टर्म फॉर अ स्पेसिफाइड पर्पस। देयर हैज टू बी अ स्पेशल पर्पस फॉर द रिलीज, लाइक देयर माइट बी अ डेथ इन हिज फैमिली, देयर माइट बी अ मैरिज इन हिज फैमिली, और देयर मे बी मेनी अदर रीजन्स। हिज हाउस माइट हैव बीन अफेक्टेड बाय अ नेचुरल कैलामिटी। So here the release is either temporary or complete before the expiry of his term. Now here this parole is granted on a promise of good behavior, and this promise is known as the word of honor. The concept of parole has been brought about in the prison system to give it a humanitarian touch. This is a reformative approach. This is a reformative method. So as we know, prisons is a state subject. Now what do we mean by a state subject? So in the constitution, in the 7th schedule, we have three lists: the union list, the state list and the concurrent list. So prisons fall under the state list. To jo bhi union list mein subjects hote hain un pe सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट लेजिस्लेट करता है, और जो फॉल करते हैं स्टेट लिस्ट में उनको स्टेट लॉज गवर्न करते हैं। सो बेसिकली प्रिजन फॉल्स इन द स्टेट लिस्ट। नाउ फॉर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ प्रिजन, फॉर ग्रांटिंग ऑफ पेरोल, फॉर लॉ, एनी प्रीमेच्योर रिलीज, वॉट एवर इज देयर, दैट इज गवर्न बाय द रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट लॉज। सो देयर आर सर्टेन एक्सेप्शंस टू एवरी रूल दैट इज मेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट। सो हियर इज द एक्सेप्शन। व्हेनेवर अ प्रिजनर इज कन्विक्टेड of multiple murders or is convicted under UAPA, then he is not eligible for parole. Now furlough, as we have already discussed, they are more or less similar in some ways. Both of them are a form of conditional release. Parole is a discretionary exercise, whereas furlough is a privilege. Now let's understand what furlough actually is. So in case of furlough, there has to be no specific reason, like in case of parole. Furlough is to be granted for no other reason than to help the prisoner to preserve his social bonds, to have a contact with his family, because as we know, furlough is granted in case of long-term imprisonment. And whenever there is a long-term imprisonment, we can see that there are various mental and physical health issues that a prisoner faces, like there is depression, there is PTSD, and there are various other problems like insomnia, social withdrawal. So this all can lead to a very hard criminal that we can make through this. So in order to bring a humanitarian touch, these two concepts are provided. So the Supreme Court has clearly distinguished between the parole and the furlough, and they have made it very clear that furlough can be claimed without a reason, but it is not an absolute legal right. So here we need to understand what is an absolute legal right. Absolute legal right is a right which can be enforced in the court. Now furlough is also conditional. It is not necessary. It is just a privilege. Furlough is a kind of privilege. It is not an absolute right. So furlough can be denied in the interest of the society. So this case is very important for us. We can use this in mains. In case of Kesar Singh Guleria, the High Court was very clear with one thing, that the act of releasing a prisoner based on his good behavior, either through parole or furlough, is not an act of charity or compassion. It is basically a discharge of a legal duty. Now we'll come to the differences between parole and furlough. So parole is granted in cases of short-term imprisonment. This is a major difference, that parole is granted in cases of short-term imprisonment, whereas furlough is granted where there is a long-term imprisonment. So the second difference is that the parole is granted to meet a specific exigency. There has to be a specific case here, whereas in case of furlough, there has to be no specific reason. The provision of the parole is a privilege, but not a right of the prisoner. So here also, parole can also be denied. Now the third difference comes is the difference of issuing authorities. Furlough is granted by the DIG of prisons, whereas the parole is granted by the divisional commissioner. Now, the fourth difference is that there is no limitation on the number of times convict can get parole. Now, the fourth difference is that there is no limitation on the number of times a convict can get parole. Whereas there is a limitation, this is a very important point, this can be asked in prelims. So, we must make notes of it. Here, convict jo hai, parole kitni bhi bahar le sakta hai, there is no limitation. Whereas in case of furlough, there is a limitation which is laid out in the rules according to each state. The sentence of the convict goes along with the furlough period. However, in case of parole, the leave days are not included in the sentence period. This is the fifth difference. This question has been asked in 2021. And after listening to this lecture, I hope you all can answer this in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching the video. See you next time.